Arun Jaitley is delivering the valedictory address at the Platinum Jubilee celebrations of Income Tax Appellate Tribunal.
Tax laws are supposed to be very strictly construed. The normal principles of interpretation of any law involve several functions. Laws are interpreted with a purposive interpretation that you give effect to the purpose why the law was enacted. You give an interpretation which will avoid a mischief, which would avoid a violation. But all these general principles of interpretation of law has two exceptions. One is the taxation laws and one is the criminal law. These are two branches of law where the simple principle is that it is the principle of strict interpretation which has to apply. In criminal law, either you have committed an offence or you have not committed an offence. Either your action falls within the parameters of an offence or it doesn't fall within the parameters of an offence. The law can't be stretched. Similarly, in a taxation law, you have to read the statute. And after you read the statute, either a tax is payable or a tax is not payable. It's white or black. There are no areas of grey in a taxation law. And therefore, laws are to be very strictly construed. And the simple principle of taxation is, even though taxation serves a very noble purpose, that it enables the state to carry on its welfare activities and developmental activities, a citizen cannot be unfairly taxed. So taxes which are payable are certainly payable, and taxes which are not payable can never be levied. Nobody can come up and say, well, on grounds of compassion, exempt or liberate me from the responsibility of paying taxes. There is no place for compassion. And at the same time, the plea that state needs more money and therefore taxation laws should be liberally construed in favor of the state is also not a plea which is available. And it is for this reason that those who framed laws at that time, and certainly it was a part of British India at that time, that and British were well known always for their commitment to the rule of law and for creating institutional mechanisms, that in 1941 the first tribunal of its kind in India was created. And a very distinguished jurist was chosen to be the president of the tribunal at that time, Justice Munir, whose name has repeatedly been mentioned. He is always referred to as a gentleman who later became the Chief Justice of Pakistan. But if I remember correctly, his most legendary contribution is his voluminous work on the law of evidence. And any law library would always have Munir's law of evidence. And I'm sure somebody now must be continuing to re-edit that monumental work that he did. And this tribunal, therefore, in 1941 became the mother of all tribunals. It was the first tribunal. Its success or failure would determine whether tribunals have to be created with regard to other areas of specialization or not. And the structure of this tribunal also was to take expertise from two different branches. You had a judicially trained mind who would be keen to interpret the law, and you will have a person with an experience of taxation. So it was a cocktail mix of two different specializations which made up for this tribunal. And since then, 75 years is a long period, it is this combination which has decided tax cases in abundance. There is an advantage in creating tribunals, and the advantage is that instead of being a general expert subject, you have people whose core competence is taxation.
Live visuals from Hotel Ashoka, where Finance Minister Arun Jaitley was speaking at the valedictory function of the Platinum Jubilee celebrations of income tax appellate jurisdiction.